Stop being afraid. Stop being afraid. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brianne. I don't give advice, suggestions, information, recommendations, or anything like that. I just share with you my perspective on different topics, as is with this one. And so I wanted to talk today about stop being afraid. You know, when I went through my little health issue a few days back, where I was 911, and you can all look back up on that video because most of you know the story, and it was kind of a suddenly type of thing that happened. It really threw me, and I became fearful. And understandable, when you go through a traumatic event, it can make you fearful, okay? It really can, if you let it. And it's very normal and natural to feel fearful after, like, oh, what's gonna happen now, or it's gonna happen again, or, you know, something different, or whatever. The other shoe's gonna drop. So, you know, we get into that fear state of mind. And that's what I did. I got into that fear state of mind because prior to that, I'd pull the back muscle. And, you know, I run 5 miles a day. I'm 64 years old. I'm very fit. And all of a sudden, I started having this self-doubt. You know, can I still run like I did before in the past? Can I still get out there? You know, which is very normal. And sometimes we have to adjust, you know, adjust our schedule or just adjust things a little bit, tweak things. I got that. And yet it put a lot of fear in me. It put a lot of self-doubt in me. And I became fearful. I became, you know, like, oh my gosh, you know, what's going to happen next? And, you know, it was very scary for me. And I realized I was becoming fearful. I was becoming fearful of that next shoe dropping or the next whatever. And I realized life can have shoes that drop, you know, whether, you know, they drop throughout life or one at a time or a lot at a time or whatever. I got that. I realized things can happen. And yet, when we start to think that that's all that's going to happen in life, or constantly happen or whatever, that can almost just stop us from doing anything in life. It can just stop us completely and most certainly stop us from living our best life. And I believe in healthy fear. I believe in recognition. I believe in acknowledging things. I believe in saying, hey, wait a minute, you know, I might have to tweak, you know, how I run and maybe make it a fast walk instead or whatever. I got all that. And yet to become fearful was not being a good thing for me. It was not helpful to me to become fearful. All the what ifs, the potential what ifs. Yes, what ifs can happen. It's just life. It's just the way things are. And yet to let that fear do that to me, I said, no, 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 no. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to replace it with positive strength thoughts. I'm going to do well. Things are going to work out. You know, I'm not acknowledging things, but I am talking positive talk because I don't want to come from a position of fear. I want to come from a position of being proactive and from strength and from power. So yes, I may need to change how I do things, you know, out on the running trail every day, and that's fine. But I want to come from a position of power, not from fear. Because fear will keep me off the running trail. Whereas coming from a position of power may say, you know, I need to tweak things a little bit, but I'm back out there again in the appropriate time. So all I'm saying is when we live in a fear state of panic and fear, and I got that and I understand it, you know, it's not going to serve us well. Whereas if we live in a position from strength and power, it tends to serve us well. From my house to yours, may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all 5 of my channels. Links are pinned at the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me with all 5, I will likely connect with you with all 5. May God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye.